Good morning. It is the 17th of September evening session of the Parayan now. This is the some administrative announcements only, including somebody announced about hall management. Pratikraman, if anybody has had difficulty because of the way the hall has been managed. This is the final day of the Parayan, Parishan Parayan, on the 17th of September 2015. This is the evening session. Aptavani 13, Volume 1, the chapter on Prakruti. We are on page 278 of the Prakruti iBook, which has got the heading, The Nature of to Become Involved in Prakruti. The nature, the Swabhaav to become involved in Prakruti and Prakruti are one. And in Gujarati, in this Aptavani book, it's a long chapter, the current chapter. It's that is on page 92. Today the chapter number 1.7 will finish, it looks like. And chapter 1.8, the knower seer of Prakruti, I suspect will carry over for the next Parayan, which is the December Parayan. As we see the car of our Gnani coming over to the Dadanagar hall, Mahatmas lined up on both sides to get his darshan. This is how long the Dadanagar hall is. Dimple Bhai driving him. And Mahatma is waiting for him inside. As he enters, he stands up. They all stand up. as the Gnani climbs up the steps of the stage leading to our Tirthankar Bhagwan, Sri Simandar Swami, Pratyaksh Dada Bhagwani Sakshiye Vartmane Mahavidya Kshetrama Vicharta, Tirthankar Bhagwan, Sri Simandar Swami ne Atyant Bhakti Purvak Namaskar Karuchu, and to Lord Sri Krishna, Pratyaksh Dada Bhagwani Sakshiye, with the presence of Dada Bhagwan as my witness, my absolute self as a witness, my highest namaskars to Lord Sri Krishna, and Shri Shri Swarup ne pan atyant bhakti purvak namaskar karu chu, to the embodiment of the salvation of the world, Lord Shiva, and Pratyaksh Dada Bhagwani Sakshiye Vartamane Sarva Kshetrama Viharman our Sarvagna Shri Gnani Purush Dada Bhagwan ne atyant bhakti purvak namaskar karu chu. Highest namaskars to the Dada Bhagwan at all locations of this universe, Dada Bhagwan, the Eternal One within all, and to Ma Amba, Ma, make me sahaj, make me natural, and to Ma Niruma, Ma, highest namaskars to you for this magnificent compilation of the Dada Vanis, and for the Aptavani 14 Volume 5, which became announced yesterday, and to Ma Padmavati Devi for protecting everyone on the path of liberation, on the Vitarag Marg. Jai Sachidananda, as the Gnani turns and faces everyone. As you take seat, and we see two magnificent images of Gnani Purush Dadashri, the big photographs, which we generally don't see in these videos. This is the last session of the Parayan, and there will be a Samai too. This is the last session of the Parayan, and this will be followed by a Samai. The nature to become involved in the Prakruti and Prakruti are one. Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand, the awareness of the eternal bliss is bliss. Within each one of you resides the Paramatma, and to that one the Absolute Self, my deepest devotion filled namaskars. Namaskars, namaskar, with oneness. Jai Sachidanand. Let us continue reading. Jai Sachidanand. Let us continue reading. Let us read further. And we are having buffering problems. And let us read further. And the nature to become involved in the Prakruti and Prakruti are one only. And therefore, Swabhaav and Prakruti are two names for the same thing. Are they different? Dadashri says, if Swabhaav nature has become pudgalmaya with the non-self, and then Swabhaav and Prakruti is one and the same. And it is a Prakruti that we call Swabhaav. This person's Swabhaav nature is like that. So that it is his Prakruti. Okay, so So, and it is the Prakruti that we call the Swabhaav. This person's Swabhaav, nature is like that, so it is his Prakruti that we refer to as Swabhaav. It is not actually Swabhaav, because Swa means self and Bhaav means view, is God. The view of the God is really the self. God is in Swabhaav. But one has a wrong belief that this is why he says that I am like this and I am a collector, I am so and so, etc. And thus he continues to suffer beatings because of that. So, Swabhaav and Prakruti. Swabhaav and Prakruti. Swabhaav and Prakruti are different. Swabhaav and So this is just a deha dhyas only. You see, Swabhava and Prakruti are considered the same, and it is possible for Swabhava to be mild. It is a Prakruti when the cow does not attack, and it is a Prakruti when it does attack. When a man is hitting another person, at that time it exists within that what he is doing is wrong. I am doing the wrong thing is called Gnan, and the one hitting is the Prakruti. Questioner, now when we say you have come into your Swabhav, who are we telling you that? Dadashri says that Swabhav is different. There we are telling one to come into Paramatma Swabhav, into the Absolute Self. You are in a different state, in the wrong state. You are in the worldly state and in the worldly state only. Come into your own state, in the state of the self. You are a Paramatma, the Absolute Self. Come into that state. God or no one else has the license to take anyone's license. The one who comes into his own state, he becomes a Paramatma. A questioner. Because circumstances come together, because circumstances come together, we're having some buffering issues with this thing here, but let us see. You see, the when circumstances come together, then it is called avastha or worldly things, you see. Go. Questioner, you come into your Swabhav means to become free of rag, dvesh, attachment, abhorrence. That can happen if one comes out of doership, you see. You see. You. Dadashri says, it is like this, that the Shuddhatma is who you are and this is your state. Now you have moved away from that, and so you have to become the state of the self by seeing that. By understanding that it is Akriya, it is like this and it is like that, become that. That from this Vyatirek or external, not intrinsic attribute has arisen, and your belief has arisen in that. So by seeing this, you have to become that form, the self, you see. He said, to believe the Vyatirek quality to be mine is called, there is bondage, but when you, Gnani Purush Dadashri makes us free from this Vyatirek quality, the extra third intention that arises, the ego, and so we come into the pure soul only, the Swabhav, the S capital, the real nature of the self, separate from, and that is, I am absolute knowledge, I am infinite, indestructible, I am unassociated, I am absolute knowledge only, I am absolute energy, I am, etc. And once he, but he otherwise, he gets into the belief that I am a man, I am a woman, etc. And so through wrong belief, he has separated from the self. And now with the right belief, he comes home to the S capital self. Prakruti will ultimately show godly qualities. No human being will refrain from showing his nature or Swabhav. As long as one has not attained the self, the nature of the self, Atma Bhav, Swabhav, cannot be seen. One can see only the nature of the pudgal, the non-self complex. And when the pervasive influence nature of the pudgal finishes and it becomes like the nature of the self, when pudgal imitates the self in exactness, then it can be said that one has attained completion, purnahuti. And all the relative viewpoint has to finish, and then one becomes established as the Atma Swabhaav, I am pure soul, and then he will come to total completion. He will become the pure soul only. The pure soul is the soul is absolute knowledge only, kevad gnan swarup. But as long as you believe that I am this body in even subtle levels, then you see your knowledge and vision will be tainted a little bit. It has to become absolute that I am pure soul only and nothing else. You see, he does not die. He does not die, you see, but his viewpoint, by real viewpoint, he is indestructible. By relative viewpoint, he changes bodies, one body after the other. And so then life after life, when he finally attains the knowledge of the self, then he begins to become absolute self. Questioner: so the main self is visible and the one becomes like the self? Dadashri says, yes. You see, pote means gnan, agnan. There is a knowledge and ignorance component. That is called pote, the I. The I is in knowledge, I is in ignorance, you see. Dadashri says, yes, I have helped you become free from insistence, is agra. So, you were not becoming all this because of the greatest of the inner pull, catch. Yes, there should not be any pull of any kind. Questioner: so, does like mimicking the main self mean gnan, darshan and charitra? Khench means willfulness, wanting to have it one way, insistence, one does not want to let go. You know, the more you enter into the relative and hold on to the relative, that by that much you will lose the soul only. So you lose your soul to the extent that you have any kind of insistence or stickiness in the relative. The more you are in the Agna, the more you will become free from the pudgal or the non-self complex. The self has got knowledge and vision, therefore he becomes the self. The non-self has got knowledge, vision at the relative level, then one becomes like the relative self, you see. There is a relative knowledge version and there is a vision of the absolute soul also. In general, just when the self pote becomes exactly how the self is, then he will become liberated. What the soul says, that is what I am seeing. What the soul knows, that is what I know. I am only the knower and seer only. I am nothing else. That is the final understanding and the vision. That is all. I am pure knowledge only and nothing else. I am a gnani. The gnani says that I am pure. I only know how to see and know. That is all. This is the gnani bhava. Dada says that the soul is the knower and seer only, and that is all I know. That is my swarup. That is my self state, and then you know, any sense that I am the knower in any other way has gone. Jan panano ahankar. I know. Any sense of I-ness, even at the subtlest level, goes away. And then he says, Chandu is Prakruti. And because Chandu is Prakruti, and therefore Chandu remains at the subtle Prakruti level. So Chandu remains at the Prakruti level, whereas at the subtlest level also, when the sense that I know goes, Janpana no ahankar, that I know, that leaves, I-ness leaves, then there is the final declaration of the Gnani, which says, I am pure, I only know that I am the knower and the seer, that is all, that I know, that is all. I am not this, I am this only, that is all. That is the reversal. So the pratikraman of Gnani Purush Dadashri is not like the pratikraman of ours, you see. His are very subtle. So does the mimicking the main self mean Gnan, Darshan and Charitra, all small G, D and C noted here? Dadashri says, just as that Gnan, Darshan and Charitra and Tap, here in the worldly interaction, there is also Gnan, Darshan, Charitra and Tap. There it is all ideal. There is no insistence or pull, etc. There is no pain at all, no destruct and construction type problems. Panjgad, that questioner. This is now the quality of how the soul has been attained and to the ultimate lid. Mruduta, Rujuta, Kshama, you see, all the natural forgiveness, you see, the natural sweetness in the way in which you deal with other people. There is absolutely zero kashais in there. This is at the relative level, all of these qualities arise within the person who has attained the absolute self. And there is no insistence, nothing. And there is a contentment, he doesn't want anything that is happening in the relative. This is the Gnan Darshan Charitra at the relative level, you see. Questioner, but this worldly interaction, vyavahar, means that it is all residual pudgal, is it not? So then which pudgal does pudgal effect? So when all the imitating play of the pudgal, when all the nature swabhav of the pudgal come to an end, and then again, Dadashri says, is this pudgal of mine not higher than yours? As it goes higher and higher, and when my 4 degrees deficiencies go away, then its form will look like God, Bhagwan. This includes my conduct and everything here. So even the body becomes God. Even the body of the Tirthankar had become God. That is why people on the outside accept it. Do they not? Questioner. So the body within is the same, but does it change in the middle? Let the body remain the same. Where does the change happen in the 4 degrees? The Dadashri says, is it because of the body within people see the weakness here? People see the weakness here because of the 4 degrees lacking. There are clothes, there is a ring, the hair is combed. This eating and everything you see, that will not be seen. And this eating that you see will not be seen in the final... questioner. So then these 4 degrees that change, the Dadashri says, that is such that even the other person will not have any doubt. You won't be able to see the extra. And then is what? So this, what is this change of the 4 degrees? Another says that is such that even the other person will not have any doubt. Questioner, internal there is complete 360 degrees, is there not? The other says, of course that will be so, will it not? Then question is, then what? The other she says, even this conduct should become like that, should it not? The external conduct. Questioner, is that considered the nature of the pudgal? So about the pudgal, yes, it is the nature of the pudgal, but it will become as if it is imitating that of God. So that is God, and this will also look like God. People will say that he is indeed God. This entire, the relative is the one's own image only. As long as, and Prakruti is the image of the ego, you see. And when the Prakruti becomes like God with egoless, absolutely, then one, the self, Gnani Purush Dadashri came into the absolute self, and therefore his body too almost became like a God with the lacking in 4 degrees only, that is all. And he is giving the photograph of his own. When he becomes 360 degrees, and then when the external will also be called Sarvagnya, the all-knowing one, you see. And see, right now his own photograph internally is now is what appears externally. This is... What is the use? Chada. What is the imitating? Chada means to becoming that. Supposing you see something in the mirror, do we not do this? Do we not do that? Do we not, supposing you raise your hand in the mirror, also you are appearing as if you are hearing. The knowledge, the Lord within is knower, seer and vitarag, absolute knower, seer and the vitarag. And then there is the interference, and then there is sahajta. So gnata, drashta, and externally there is sahajta, you see. Internally, and if there is no interference, then it is sahaj. And yes, internally there is absolute God only. Externally there is absolute naturalness. So then there is no ego at all. So 1 to 299, one is a vikalpi. I am this only, I am uve or I am nada. And then 300 to 360, one is a gnani, but a developing gnani. And at 360 degrees, one becomes a God, a perfect God. In which way I am a God, then I am infinite knowledge, infinite vision, infinite bliss, infinite energy. And then there is an absolute, continuous, complete knower and seer only and nothing else. So today's Prakruti is discharging. And then it is a result of the causes that were created in the last life. And you know, I used to believe I'm a thief, I'm the one who stole, etc. And now the I has separated out completely from the real viewpoint and by the relative viewpoint, I'm a thief, I did this, I did that. This by this, so there is, you know, that I'm a donator, I'm donate a lot of money, I'm a stealer, I'm a steal, etc., I'm a thief, etc. So the Dadashri has made you kind of forget and separate from the relative and move in the direction of the real only. And then you have become the pure soul at 300 degrees and then you move towards 345 degrees where you will be a Gnani. Then from 345 to 359, you continue to remain a Gnani, you see. But it's in Gnan Vidhi, you get such a magnificent reception of the soul only, and you get also the five agnas, which will sustain that state, which will make you move in the direction of the self only and nothing else. I see. So there is Nishchay Gnan Darshan Charitra and Tap with all capital G, Gnan Darshan Vision Charitra and Tap, you see. And then there is the Vyavahar Gnan Darshan Charitra and Tap, which is the small G, small D, small C and small T for, you know. You see. So, and then if he realizes that the relative at the relative level is under the influence of scientific circumstantial evidences due to external pressures, then he will not even go there, he will not even try to enter there, and he will be aware of the evidentiary pressures only. And you know, he will never say that this got spoiled or this got spoiled or this happened or I did this or you know that other person is doing it. He will remain absolutely separate from it, you see. And he will say, in conduct and knowledge and vision, the soul is absolutely separate. And also, and Nishchay is already separate, but also in conduct, the self is absolutely soul also separate, you see. At the relative level, the soul also is separate. It is due to the wrong belief only that it appears that I am doing this. And as long as the wrong belief is there, he continues to charge a little. But you know, when he is absolutely established in this, the absolute self, and also at the relative worldly interactions, he does not interfere in the worldly interactions at all, then he remains separate. So Nishchay, the original self is absolutely unaffected in this, that is the sun, and then there is the Nishchay Atma, and this, the original self is absolutely unchanging and doesn't change at all. This is all relative. In the relative level interactions, it appears that it is unstable, etc. When you see, in this way, hundreds of thousands of phases of the soul have become tainted, and therefore, you know, it happens, becomes by you become Tanmayakar, you become Tadrup, you become that only, you see. You believe that I am this body, that I, this is happening to me, that I, these are my words, etc. I am the one who is doing it. But now you know that whatever is shaking up or is changing, I am not that, I am the pure knower, seer only. And therefore, he continues to return home only. What is Atma? You see, you are really, I am unstable, but you believe that I am unstable and changing, and therefore, because of your wrong belief, you are unstable, and when your wrong belief goes away, then you will become stable and still again. Through Nishchay, you are unstable, and so both ways, either in Nishchay and Vyavahar, you will become absolutely stable. When the wrong belief is taken away, when the Vyati... You see, Gnan Darshan Charitra and Tap, you see, when it, at the four levels he becomes one, then he will become that only. We have only 15%, we have 100% conviction, 15% awareness and 2% experience, you see. And you see, and that is 2% experience is the reason why we have the full prajna. You see, that is the prajna is there, and as we arise in our awareness by the application of our conviction, then in one or two more lifetimes the experience will become complete, that is all, through the five agnas. Somebody is asking more. The inner state of Dada. Yeah. It's the language such that the one who is remaining in Prakruti should understand God. It's the Pratishthita Atma, he says, believes that the discharge to be I, you see. And you see, now he is not the doer. As soon as he lets go hold of, Vyavahara Atma is charging, Pratishthita Atma is discharging. You see, it is his one, his, you know, whatever his belief is, that is what arises externally in his vision, yes, in his, that's how he appears. And you see, and therefore he says the external portion has to become God. And when you see, we, external means the shadow can only become still if you are, I become still. The worldly interaction self is nothing but the shadow of the self only. When I become absolutely still, then my shadow too will become absolutely still, and that is a worldly interacting self, you see. This is the internal stillness is the critical thing which really then results in the external stillness only. You see, so the God now doesn't do ragdvesh at all, but you see, the one who used to do ragdvesh has now become vitarag. You see, in the before, in the, so in the developing Gnani, there was from 1 to 359, there was the beginning of the ragdvesh from which he became progressively free from it. And you see, so it is the entire shadow of the S capital self, the absolute self, and enters into the Prakruti only, and therefore the more you still become inside, the more still the shadow will be. I understand that the last 4 degrees are essentially. And then, you know, you can see the Gnani Purush eating, sleeping, etc. These are the subtlest mistakes remaining of the Gnani. And then, and when I come into Ahmedabad, the moment I enter Ambalal, then I see these errors in the world. But you see, but the moment I step away from Ambalal, the world is absolutely flawless, is it not? Because he becomes Ambalal, then he is in the result of Dehadiyas. You know, he is talking about when Dada had liked eating hot chilies, you see, and when the hot chilies, all the flavor for that also went away, then he says, we rose by 2 degrees. You see, in our experience, we know that the world is absolutely flawless, and in our experience also, when in our relative experience also, we see that the world is absolutely flawless. Then there is the absolute knowledge, gnan, darshan, and charitra will arise, and you see, in vartan, in conduct, there may be a little bit of a leakage where we say that the world is a little at flaw. You see. In 1973-74, the speech that was coming out, by then there was a lot of difference between 73-74 speech versus 1978 speech, you see. And there was amazing amount of pratikraman pratyakhyan happening during that time. And as a result of which, he said, this is the interpretation of Deepak Bhai, that as a result the speech changed completely. And the you see, what you see externally is your touch point between your absolute self versus your entry into the world. The Gnani Purush recognizes that this is the Uday, the unfolding only. But in that unfolding, it is called Charitra Moha, in the discharging conduct only. There is no absolutely charge only. This is the subtlest Charitra Moha, the illusory discharging illusion of the Gnani Purush. Is he able to see all of this in Akram only, or this is also compared to Kramik? No, this is the Akram only, because he has absolutely become the absolute self inside. But he is able to see from there, he is able to describe it. Questioner. Then he says that the Lord God has got knowledge, vision, darshan, as well as knowledge, darshan, charitra, and tap with a capital. And then there is at the relative level, there are the kashais. And then once the kashais go away, No, no. It's not there. What is sahajama? Then nirlopta, nirdosh, arjavta, sarvata, mardavta, namrata, komarta, lagav, raguta, satya, sanyam, then brahmacharya, Ramacharya. These are all the qualities of samkiti. These are from the scriptures, you see. And now this is namrata, humility, sarvata, straightforwardness, you see. In the real is absolute, and the relative, these qualities that are apparent to the others come out, you see. You see, there is no greed at all, Abha. There is absolutely an absence of anger, pride, deceit and greed. There is none of these, externally, when there is naturalness and natural forgiveness, that means straightforwardness and for natural forgiveness, that means he is in the absolute state only, you see. And so this is, internally it is that, and therefore externally these magnificent qualities appear, which is associated with naturalness. There is no interference at all. There is no interference of this S capital self at all, pote, now, because he has become established as the self only, you see. There is nothing to interfere into now. Now let us now Gnani stops here somewhere, will become like God. Will he, the whole Prakruti, become like God? Yes, if others see for forgiveness such humility, such simplicity and straightforwardness and such contentment like a God, there is no effect of anything at all. There is no component of I-ness, potapanu. All the above attributes can be seen by people. A lot more attributes will express and be evident. And these new qualities are neither of the S-capital self nor of the pudgal. Such quality attributes just simply arise. And I think this is where now we stop for this Parayan on page 287, you see. We have some very good news coming up now. Deepak Bhai is saying, everybody clap, there is good news coming up now. Some more good news for Mahatmas of Dadashri all over the world. On the Janma Jayanti of Gnani Purush Dadashri, they are going to announce where it is going to happen. And in Maharashtra, for the first time outside Gujarat, the anniversary of Dadashri's birth, Janma Jayanti, is celebrated every time. It has got the same importance as Guru Purnima and Diwali, the special New Year celebration. So this Janma Jayanti is going to happen in November, and this is going to be celebrated in Pune, India, which is in another state called Maharashtra, and a very beautiful place, you know. I'm requesting all Maharashtra Mahatmas to come up over here, please. All the Mahatra centers, please come here. And it means from Mumbai and Pune, etc., Aurangabad, Amravati, all the other, you see, Mumbai, Pune, Amravati, Aurangabad, these are all cities of Maharashtra, you see, so they're all standing up now, Maharashtra. And these are all here to invite, with a live invitation, they are here to invite everyone to come to. And so if they are all sitting, everybody else sitting, you know. So now Deepak Bhai, this is for all the Mahatmas in Hindi and for their friends. On the 108th Janma Jayanti of Gnani Purush Dadashri, 108, which is a very auspicious number, and you see, it is going to be a very magnificent occasion from 24th to 29th November. This is going to be celebrated. All Mahatma Maharashtras, we are inviting you to come. Come with your friends and your families, please. And so please attend, so it will become a magnificent occasion of celebration. This is very good news. We want your blessings, that all Sevarthis, all the people who are in Pune, here through the grace of Gnani Purush Dadashri and Dada Bhagwan, this will happen. You can see this is, all the people from India are going to come. Because it will be in Hindi, the entire Shibir is going to be in Hindi. You see, this is also, it's going to be in a new language, Hindi only. The entire anniversary will be in Hindi for the first time. And also from Aurangabad, this is Ashok Bhai Niruma's brother who just announced that please come. And so, Niruma used to be in Aurangabad, and this is Ashok Bhai who just announced, please come, you see. So, and it's in, I'm originally born in Morbi, but all my life I was in Mumbai, so I'm considered also a Maharashtrian in some sense. Dada used to be in Vadodara, but all of his activities were happening and his business was happening in the Patel building in Mumbai also. See, Dadashri of Gnani Purush also is also, can be considered Mumbai or Maharashtra, you see. Mumbai is, by the way, is not in Gujarat, it is in the state of Maharashtra. So everybody now just kind of celebrating with clapping. Everybody clapping, thousands. A song for Pune has been arranged. It's in, I think, Marathi. A new song that has been just recorded. We cannot hear it very well. Let's see if we can increase the volume. Now we get a panoramic view of all the Mahatmas in this. Everybody will come, right? Yes. There'll be no problem to listen to it in Hindi, right? Yes, everybody says yes. There's another, some more news coming up. Simandar Swami is coming to Vadodara. There is going to be a Sri Mandir in Simandar Swami. Lord Simandar Swami Sri Mandir in Dadashri is Vadodara. This is a very big news now also. It is as big as Adalaj. Just whatever, the same kind of such huge big Bhagwan will be there in the Vadodara in Baroda. Now Sri Mandir going to happen in Vadodara. It is on the 6th of October, there is a Bhumi Pujan, the ground breaking ceremony. Everybody is welcome to come to 6th of October. On the 6th of October, and that in so that in this work will happen without any obstructions. So let us, this is magnificent news. In the other Shri's Vadodara, there is going to be a Sri Mandir. There is already one, but this is going to be the second one under the leadership and under the organization of Dada Bhagwan Foundation. There is already one over there as the Sri Mandir at Kelanpur. So this is going to be the second one. There is one Sri Mandir is already on the 6th March, Anjar will be ready. Lord, on the 6th March, there will be a Pran Pratishtha of Lord Simandar on 6th of March, and we will all go there on March in Anjar, which is in the deserts of Saurashtra. Anjar happened to be the epicenter of, and then we have now the Dada Darshan, the first Lord. And then all the various, Dada Darshan, Adalaj in 2002, Rajkot in 2006. And then in Bhuj in 2009, and then in Godhra in 2011, and then in Morbi in 2013, and then in Surendranagar in 2014, and then in Amreli in 2015, and now Nina Asim Jai Jai Karhu Dad. So. And now it is going to be through Now this is the Karma Bhumi. This is where Dadashri got raised, you know, grew up, and this is in Vadodara. And now they are showing the model of the Tri Mandir in Vadodara. And it is all going to happen. This is the architectural model. Manana Asimajay. It is going to be as big. And this is the Bhagavan. And so it is going to rise in Vadodara. This is going to be a 13-foot big Simandar Swami Lord in Vadodara. Tri Mandir, October 6th, there will be the ground laying ceremony in Vadodara. And this, all of these dirasars that are being built, says Gnani Purush Dadashri. Now the aerial views of all of these that have been built. And they are meant to get rid of all of these insistences and opinionated divisiveness, matarth, in the people of India, so that they can come to the level of the soul only, to the vision of the soul. Because as long as there is divisiveness in the name of religion, one cannot hope to enter into the religion of the soul. So these are the words of Gnani Purush Dadashri. So this is the Trinishpakshpati, this is Tri Mandir in Vadodara will arise. In Vadodara, which is Baroda. Jai Sachidanand. So the Vadodara Mahatmas are asked to come forward. So now the Gnani is coming to the QA levels. So the Mahatmas are all just before the break in the evening session here. This is the evening session on the last day of the Parayan. Jai Sachidanand Mahatmas. And so these are all the surrounding Mahatmas. Please, everybody will stand up. All the Mahatmas will stand up. Everybody please stand up. In Gujarat, Bharat. And from and all the whether they are here, all of whom here watching, please, there, everybody on the live on TV also, and also please, it is going to be a magnificent Tri Mandir that will happen in Vadodara, and please have the greatest energies fill in. Everyone who come to Baroda, they will get the subatomic particles of Dada, and so that, because this is the original city of Dada, Vadodara, and therefore please, and this is a very big invitation to everybody, so please come, Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand. Dada is from Vadodara, and we are all of Dada, and this is where it's going to happen. So all of you, and please, we would like for all of you to enter into this. Please enter into this bhavanas. Please remain with us. Oh no, we need this. This is our invitation to you for the Tri Mandir of Dada. We are making the, with a lot of humility, we are requesting Pujishri to bless all of us, all the Mahatmas of in a magnificent Tri Mandir arise in Vadodara. You see, this is a very major news, and a major news for Vadodara, because this was going to be, this was the main city in which most of the satsangs of Gnani Purush Dadashri happened in this world. You know, so now when this Dada has got the greatest blessings, because Dada Srimandir will happen where Lord Srimandir will come, and it will, without any obstructions, a magnificent work will happen there in Vadodara. It will happen. It will all complete there. Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand. So there is on the 4th and 5th March, there is Satsang plus Gnanvidhi and Anjar too. Anjar on the 4th March and 5th March, there is a Gnanvidhi and Anjar. So please, you are all welcome to come in Anjar. In the 6th March, is the Gnan Day of Pujyashri. March 6 is the Gnan Day of Pujyashri, and that is the day of the Pratishtha in Anjar. Anjar. So everybody has to come to Anjar for the Gnan Day of our Gnani Pujyadipak Bhai. That is his Gnan Day. And then he will finish 45 years of Gnan on the day. Because he received Gnan, we have the magnificent, glorious beneficiary of his knowledge that he received 45 years ago on March 6th, 2016, you see, from Gnani Purush Dadashri at the age of 17. So 17 plus 45 is how old or how young our Gnani Pujyadipak Bhai is. So now, this is a break now. So let us, we'll be back with you after the break. So this is the last session now, the post break in the evening. The question and answer sessions followed by the final samayik of this Parishan Parayan of 2015 in September, in the last day, 17th of September 2015 in the evening. Some major good news announcements were made of Janma Jayanti in in Pune, P-U-N-E, India, and then the construction of a three mandir in Vadodara, and also the final gate opening ceremonies during the March 4th, 5th and 6th, 6th March being the Gnan Day, the 45th Gnan Day of our Gnani Deepak Bhai in Anjar, as we see our Gnani. Go through various bunch of questions that are there, still there in front of him. Let us take a few questions now. Bhikkhu Paidar Ji Chand Kheda. So various questioners have been announced. Jai Sachidana. Niruma used to do pratikraman for hours altogether. What was she doing for 2 to 3 hours? She used to do a lot of pratikramans. You know, at least forget about the 2 to 3 hours. At least, can you do you not know where you miss the 5 agnas? Wherever you, which agna did you miss during all day? Which agna you did you miss the agna of Yavasthit? Did you miss meet the agna of file with equanimity? Did you miss the agna of seeing the real and the relative separate? You see. Did you see him as the doer? Did you see that? Did you remain? Did you like this? Did you see him as a file? Did you see in with equanimity? This is all. Even if you do it about 10 to 15 hours, 10 to 15 minutes a day, then you see your energies will rise in terms of so clear up. It's just apply the vision to how to see the pure in everyone. That is all. Hello, next. Yes, Achyut. Chaya Shah, today is my birthday. Please bless me that I move forward and then I want to do Alochana Pratikraman of file 2 today because it is my, shall I call him? Yeah, call him, yes. She wants to do open Pratikraman of her file 2. And who else is next? This is her birthday today. She wants blessing from him. Then there is Gaishreva, Gohil Bhavnagar. Okay, so now the husband is going to come of the gentleman. Vinod Jethwa. Yes, sir. And I too have hurt my file to my wife a lot with my speech. And I want to also ask for forgiveness live in front of you. I want to get your blessings to remain in the 5 agna and settle the rest of the life with equanimity. Settle all files with equanimity. Come forward now, yes. Come near the stage and do the pratikraman, open live pratikraman. And you will see what they do. Now third one. Jai Sachidanand. Nansu Kasani. You talk about this Dako interference. I have one question. Let them finish their pratikraman and then we can talk about it. Let's see. Yes, do it. They are not on video. So this is the wife joining in front of the husband, doing namaskars, asking for forgiveness. And then the husband in front of the wife asking live pratikraman. And the open pratikramans, you see. Do you want to say anything? Do you want to say anything? Yes. I want. Now we are the only two, our files have gone. Please bless us that we do the work of Dada only. Please bless us. Jai Sachidanand. Yes, he says. Next. Another couple coming and the gentleman has gone flat. This is called Shashtang Dharma Pranam. So he has gone absolutely flat in front of her. And she bends in a curved fashion. So and then he does it in front of his daughter. He asks for all the forgiveness from his own daughter. And the mother also and the mother, the daughter, while Dada Bhagwan Asin Jai Jakar Ho is being sung by the Mahatmas who are present there. And both the files are such that they have never hurt me anyone, but I have not remained, looked backwards in hurting them. I have spoken curses. I have... But these two have never hurt me. I have thrown things at them. I want to... Everybody believes that I am good externally. But I am not that. I am very terrible inside. I want to really open up all my faults inside. And say, I have everything, I have been very willful. All the mistakes that have been expressed subtly here, all of them I have done. I have beaten my daughter, I have cursed her, etc. So I have mistreated her, I have abused her, so please forgive me. The biggest thing is that she is the one who brought me to Dada. It is because of her that we are in Dada. Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand. Speak, Dansukh Bhai. Jai Sachidanand. I have a question. We have a joint family. There are divisive differences due to opinions. Should the senior gentleman like me enter into the fights in the family, in the joint family, or are they here? Yes, slowly you should just say, okay, let us come to some kind of conclusion, and why are we fighting within the family structure only? Let us talk about it. Let us come to some kind of solution with love, humility, and the right approach. It is not called interference, it is called, you are doing it to settle the files with equanimity, you're doing it to bring closure. You are not doing it anything negative. You're trying to bring some closure within the family. That is why you're doing it. We want to understand what is happening inside. We want to see the positive evidences also. And when we want to see the positive of the other person, then in this way, very beautiful things will. Then the second part is that if they do come to satsang, then there will be a very beautiful result. And it will become, the solutions will come rather easily if they all come to satsang. Jai Sachidanand. Bhikkhu Bhai Darji. Is Prakruti and opinion the same, or is it separate? I always see negativity in other people's, Sometimes I have negativity that if I don't meet them, it will be good, you see. I have negative thoughts that, I wish I don't meet them again. I have those kind of thoughts. Is this my Prakruti or is it my opinion? Prakruti is the result of causes of last life, so then what should I do? Prakruti is a total thing, and one part of the Prakruti is opinion. You see, if you change your, yes, you should change your opinions through knowledge and gnan, that one person is not the same or negative all his life. You see, he may improve too. So we want to know what has happened. We want to become free from it. We really need to see the pure soul. It is a pure soul. We need to see that it is a file that we want to settle with equanimity. The more you remain in five agnas and the awareness of five agnas, then you will have the awareness that this was not correct, you see. So as we become free from opinions, then we will become, love will arise there. Supposing there are two brothers, supposing I have hurt my brother and my brother has hurt me, are they here? At least if you have hurt him, then you have to do pratikraman. If he has hurt you, then you have to say that he is flawless. What I had given to him in a previous life is coming back to me now. And once you clear off this step 2 and step 1, step 2, you will have beautiful results. I have a very strong habit of smoking, and I'm trying very hard to try to get free from smoking, I one day make a very deep nishchay, then we will give you the blessing, says Deepak Bhai. Then Jai Shri Ba. Then Niranjan Thakur. And then Bharati Goswami in Bharuch. Then Hina Kabadiya Surat. Jai Sachidanand Deepak Bhai, I want to do open pratikraman from my file 2. This is my husband. Call him. Yes, I want to I want to call him and I want to do open pratigraha. Please file 2. He's just saying file 2. Call him. It's usually the ladies who start this. The gentlemen very rarely initiate this. Then who else are there? Here, there's another one. Ranjan Thakkar. File 2 is here. He has the habit of very smoking of tobacco. And we have 2 sons. Both her daughter-in-laws are here. But I do hurt my daughter-in-laws because of ignorance, and I want to do open pratikraman. Why didn't you? But I want to do that in front of them. Call them. Yes, she's going to call. She's the mother-in-law with 2 daughter-in-laws. And her husband, she is going to do open pratikraman, alochana pratikraman. Alochana she has already done, confession she has already done. Now she is going to ask for forgiveness, open forgiveness, by lying prostrate in front of everyone. And here are the people coming slowly. Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand. So there is the first one. The lady goes flat in front of her husband. And then he signals her to stand up. And he will do likewise. And that is her son coming up now. And their daughter is also there. So son and a daughter are coming. And then the father goes flat in front of the daughter while the mother kneels. And then the mother goes flat in front of the daughter and the son curves. Going flat is absolute surrender. Shashtang Dandvat Namaskar Pranam. All the parts of the body are touching the floor. You see, so now she is saying, you know, I have hurt him a lot. When they were young, when she talks about the family to the others, then I would be. And once I had beaten him with a belt. I cannot remain in. I have also hurt him a lot, you see. Well, too. But now it is all over, is it not? But even then, I keep on remembering it. Please, okay, today you have washed it off. You see, now live with love also, right? Live in love. Don't hurt him and remain in love only. As many times I have beaten her, he says, physically beaten her. But after Gnana, I have not hit her. But now let us finish this, you see. Let us clear it all up. Everybody, we are all in Gnana. You see, the daughter and the son are such that they never hurt me at all. They are very nice to us, you see. But the mistake is mine only, Deepak Bhai. Then you should remain in the awareness only. Let it must proceed in love only. Please bless me, that bless us. We do not ever want to repeat such mistakes, Vama, Deepak Bhai, Jai Sachidanand. And then the son also said that give us the energy so that we will never repeat this in future, you see. You see, give us the energy. Jai Sachidana. Next one. Now the next one is coming. So they're singing and the gentleman is going in front of his wife. And their daughter is there, and also to his daughter, he is doing namaskars. And the daughter first goes to the mother and the Gnani is watching very carefully with a lot of compassion in his eyes as they both ask for his forgiveness. And they will be given the microphone in case they want to say something. And there is one more relative that is there. The two daughter-in-laws are there. You see, these are the two daughter-in-laws who are asking for forgiveness. And you can see the little one who just went completely flat in front. And this little boy is doing, just imitating, learning from the parents, you see, of how to ask for forgiveness. You see, and you can see increasing compassion in the eyes of the Gnani as we see this very, very beautiful scenes, you see, through. Do you want to say something to the mother-in-law? Yes, Achidar. They are all very beautiful people. Yes, it is our mistake only. You know, our daughter-in-laws are like our daughters only. You see? They are studied there. They have gone through college only. I say, this is you. We have your understanding. We have Gnan. Everything is doing very beautifully. You see? And let us live in love only, you see. Very good. But he, you know, she is more worried that he is an eater of tobacco. Stop bickering. The day you stop bickering about his tobacco, the tobacco will go away, gives Deepak Bhai the answer. Bless us that we can live in love as a family. He says, he is now saying that I am going to totally give it up, you see. I am going to give it up. I used to chew tobacco, but I am going to give it up today only, he says. He says, I am always very, very angry, says the first daughter-in-law. I can see my anger only. And let me, grant me the energy so that I cannot see anybody's faults. I want to see the other people as flawless only. I had a lot of negative opinions about everyone. And so I had some deep intent negative opinions about these people. So please grant me the energy to remain in the five agnas. If you see the pure soul and see the filled stock of the Prakruti and you know the real and the relative, this is how you'll become free, you see. This is how you'll become free. Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand, says the little one. Yeah. Then there is Hina Ben Kabaria, Nita Thakkar, Bhavna Pitwa, Uma Patel. So, we don't know whether these are people who have questions or who want to do the open alochana, pratikraman and pratyakhyan, open. Usually the technique is to do it silently inside, but occasionally it is done in front of the Gnani. I have seen a lot of mistakes. I have seen a lot of mistakes of other people. Bhavna Ben Pitwa, I have seen a lot of mistakes of other people. Will you remain in the awareness? I cannot remain in the awareness. Are you doing the Charanvidhi? Are you writing the nine columns? Are you doing the nine columns? I do it. I read them. Then ask for the energies from Dada only. I have spoken a lot of negative of other people. I have seen a lot of negativities. You see, I have opened up a lot of my negativities to the others and now they talk negative about it. Remain in the awakened awareness only. Grant me the energy. Thank you. Next one. In understanding the Samayik, I came to understand that there is, you know, that I want the entire cake and I want to eat it too. I don't want to share it with anyone. I am deeply greedy. I'm deeply hungry. I want to take care of the file one only. I want to enjoy the worldly pleasures only. I want everything. I just only want to get it. I don't care about others. I am deeply selfish. And then I want to appear nice to others. I want to impress others. I understand that this is all my mistake only. And this has heavily happened within me. But now it used to happen, but now I can see that it is happening, and therefore there is a lot of dvesh inside for the pratikraman. Are you doing pratikraman? But are you coming to satsang? Does she come to satsang? So isn't she, it's good that she comes to satsang, all the junk will... You see, if by 2% she is good, right? So if she is coming, she is doing this, she has got the desires to apply the agnas of dada, and then do you want to become weak through, you know, she doesn't want to become weak through these mistakes, you see. So see the right as right, see the wrong as wrong, see the good as good, and see the bad as bad, that is all. But I want to get out of it. The moment you see the mistake, and then he says, you just have to tell Umaben, do the pratikraman. Is she doing pratikraman? That means you will become free from it. If you had not met Dada, where would you be? Where would you be if you had not met Dada? And so therefore you have to understand that this is, you know, so with whatever it happens, this is very beautiful. Therefore, we need to be in the purusharth of the self only. Do you understand the nature of the Prakruti? Grant me the energy to remain in awareness and do a samayik every day. And I want to ask for forgiveness from all the family members of mine, you see. Jai Sachidanand. Mukesh Patel, Mumbai. Let us now, it's time to just, for the train is now going to leave the station. So now, I cannot settle file 2 with equanimity. Please, I want to ask for forgiveness because I cannot settle my file 2, my wife's problems, with equanimity. Please forgive me. Now let us talk about samayik now. We are going to talk for samayik at 35 minutes and 51 seconds in this. This is the final samayik, by the way. Usually the topic is the same in all final samayik. Who are you going to ask for forgiveness? What will you ask for? What is the mistake yours or his, hers? Then it is my mistake only. So I have to ask for the forgiveness. So now wisen up. But when it happens, ask for the energies from Dada to have the energies never to do this again. Oh, Dada Bhagwan, please grant me the energy not to do this again. And so he is asking for the energy, and he is going to go. His name is, and then now she is going to come in front of her. And Jai Sachidanand, Jai Sachidanand. And the woman continues to remain prostrate in front of the gentleman. Jai Sachidanand. Do you want to say something? No. Live with love, okay? And live in such a way that you will not hurt each other. You know, do not hurt each other. Let us talk about samayik now. This is Parishan, this is the last day. Especially with reference to the sticky files. And with our close sticky files in colleagues in the work that we do, whether we do spiritual work or in satsang or in work related matter, we need to see our own mistakes, and let us be deeply repentant about our mistakes, and we make that we have done this same thing. So we have done the same thing with this sahadhyayos. Sahadhyay means being spiritual colleagues only. And there it is with them that we have entered into them with rag and vesh, and And also with competitiveness and rivalry and backbiting and finding faults with them. And that is why our life after life we have done that, and that is why in the fifth era of the time cycle, where there is no unity of mind, speech and body, and you know, when if our pride is nurtured, then we feel we are positive, and the pride is kicked, we become negative. When you know, when our willfulness is not nurtured, then we see the negativity of the other person. You see, and so we should understand that we should understand that those people are not at all at fault. It is whether it is pride or attachment or moha. If I see any mistakes of others, then it is my own ego related mistake only. It is my own extra ego of superiority. Everybody should listen to me. Whatever I say, they should understand. You know, everybody should understand, you know, if I say it's morning, they should say, everybody should say morning, whether it is morning or not. You know, if they disagree with you, if they move in a slightest different direction from you, then you become upset with them. So when are you going to make this kind of adjustments? So therefore, we should make the firm nishchay, the firm determination that it is all the mistakes of file one only, it is not the mistake of anyone, it is the ego of file one only, that is the problem, you see. If there is the slightest suffering because of any nimit externally, then it is my own mistake only. I need know this. And the day you become free from your own mistakes, then you will not find any external nimit to be at fault at all, and you will absolutely see the other person as flawless. So it is our merit karma that has. It is because of the merit karma unfolding that other people are mistreating us, and they therefore. So when things do not happen according to your wishes, that means it is, you see, then you should find that as a beneficial thing that is helping to you. Therefore, you will be able to see where you are wrong in life, you see. And so, but you see, when ours get spoiled, therefore you become more aware that who am I? Am I the doer, or is some other energy the doer? You see, therefore, do I want to run my world, or shall I allow the vyavasthit to run the world? You see, and once you understand and accept vyavasthit, then you will be in the state of the pure soul, and you will be able to become free from it. Because otherwise, you will also always be complaining about other people. They are all willful. They always want to have it their way. And I'm the old Mahatma, these are all new Mahatmas, you see, you know. So you have all kinds of negativity that your intellect will show you, but in all of this that you should understand that this is the fault of the ego only, this is my own pride, this is my own the expectations, this is my own willfulness, that is why I expect it to be this way. Therefore, when in world interaction, if it doesn't happen according to our interactions, then we have to recognize that this is wrong only. So therefore we have to recognize all of this, you see. Actually, it is, the life is such that no one can interfere with any other living being in this. When the ego, the fault of the ego goes away, then you will not find any negativity in the world, you will not see anybody at fault at all. And for to become that, we are entering into seva and satsang, service and satsang, and this is why we are entering into the service of Jagat Kalyan of Dada, you see. Therefore, and you know, no matter how somebody might hurt you, you should say that he is flawless only, that awareness must remain. And we need to come to that level of understanding and to that state only. Dadashri says, the moment I become Ambalal, I can see somebody's mistake. But if I reverse back to Dada Bhagwan, the Absolute Self, then I will not see anybody's mistakes only. Therefore, we need to remain in the pure soul and never enter into the level of the ego. Into the state of the ego. And so now even, you know, no matter how negative it may be, when somebody else's negativity arises, we should arise this. No. If supposing somebody talks to you negatively about somebody, you should say, please do not tell me. Don't you think we ourselves have this kind of negativities within? So we should not talk about negative about anybody else. And therefore we should have our own, should clear up to the, so such a magnificent extent that we should not see a faults of anybody externally. And if we hurt anyone, we should not have any such negativity at all. Niruma says that this is on the first day, this is what I got from Dada. Then I say, I know, no, I will be suffering the effects of my own mistakes, so nobody else is at fault at all. This is the first thing that I learned from Dada, says Niruma. You know, it is on the basis of our own cause that we get the results only. If we do not do rag dvesh, then we will, nothing negative will arise in front of me. And it is our rag dvesh comes out on the basis of the file only, and the file is the reason why which stirs up our rag dvesh, and therefore this is, it gives us the opportunity to reverse and come back to who we are through the five agnas. And so five agnas is the most critical, and five agnas is such that you will make see the world as flawless, and the five agnas is such that you will be become absolutely free from any kind of suffering at the relative level. And if you must understand that who is suffering, what is the fault of the nimitta in this. And so today we will do a fantastic amount of awareness, and with this awareness we will clear all the sticky files, whether it is at home or whether it is at, in the spiritual work that we are doing, or whether it is at the colleague levels and work also, or in business, you see. And you know that by relative, it is a filled stock, it is relative, really they are pure soul only. Whatever has happened is correct and is vyavasthit, you see. I am pure soul, that is, you know, that's I am pure soul. You see, I am pure soul. Whatever happens is happening to Uvi, it's happening to Nada, it is happening to Grit, you see, that is all. And you see, we need to, you see, if the accounts are not complete, then what is going to happen? We will not be able to complete it. Therefore, we have to finish the accounts that have been created in the last life and that are arising in front of us, and that we have to do a magnificent samayang to. So, please sit here. In it, we will do the samayik through excellent upyog, the applied awareness, and with, you know, let us be deeply repentant for any hurt caused to any such sticky files at the family level, at the spiritual level, at the spiritual colleague level, or at the level of the level of the work and the work level, you see, and the outsides. Otherwise, you see, so we need to really do this. The knowledge is so beautiful that it will allow you to become free and absolute. Therefore, and so we must not see anyone in this world to be at fault at the slightest level, you see. And it is on the parishan in samasari nimit, you see. We really need to become, we want to really be. And so life after life, you see, even if one file is remaining pending in this life, then you will have to face that file in the next life. So you need to really become free from all of this in this very life. Why don't we really finish it, then, all the files in this life? Let us clear up all the files in this life. Let us do a beautiful vidhi now. Let us grant the take the blessings of Dada Bhagwan within all of us, you see. And therefore, and it be, Dada, it is my own rag dvesh, my own attachment, aversion, reactions is the reason why I see faults in others. I want to become absolutely free from all of these kashayas within me. Let us do the vidhi. Oh Dada Bhagwan, the absolute self within me. Oh Sri Simandar Swami Prabhu, the perfect Lord at Mahavidik Kshetra, with the exact applied awareness of the pure self, Shuddha Upyog, in all the sticky files in life, whether they are at the spiritual colleague level, whether they are in the home and in the close relationships in the family, whether they are in the home, whether they are at, in good close friends, whether in any way, whichever sticky file comes close to me, in that sticky file, today, With each fault that has happened through rag, dvesh, attachment, aversion, I would like to become free from my own mistakes in this, and I would like to settle that file with equanimity and clear that file, and in this way I can win all the files with gnan. If any negativity is seen of anyone, if any mistakes are seen of anyone, I say that those mistakes exist within me only. And so to clear off all of those mistakes within, and let me see the files as absolutely flawless, At the real level, they are the pure souls. Let me clear each one of those accounts of each files and grant me the energy to do to this samayik, such samayiks, my Lord. I surrender the mind, speech and body, all illusions associated with my name, bhav karma, charge karma, dravya karma, subtle discharge karma, yellow glasses, no karma, gross discharge karma. O Dada Bhagwan, the absolute self within me, you are the manifest self within me, you are the Paramatma Swarup God, you are the manifest Lord God within me, and it is at your divine feet, Sucharano, I am doing the total surrender, I am surrendering them, samarpan to you. Shuddhatma chuh, 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 That much, who should that much? Eu so am a pura, 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 eu so am a pura. Eu so am a pura, eu so am a pura, ich bin reine Seele, 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 Jai Satchidanand, Jai Satchidanand. Apply the five agnas beautifully and then remain opinion free and then see all the mistakes of file one and see the flawless everywhere around it. Do very strong pratikramans today, you see. The Jai Satchidana.